नमस्कार प्रणाम। माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर शिवा कर पाठक एवेलेबल विथ यू इन लेबोरेटरी ट्रूथ जस्टिस एंड होम एंड आफ्टर वेलकमिंग यू आई फील happiness and prosperity in my soul, which makes to join with you. Today, we are here with you to one more fresh lecture on human value in Vedanta Darshan. So let us move towards them. Lecture. Today, human value in Sankhya Yoga and Vedanta Darshan. We are going to see lecture number 20, in which we will discuss about obstacle in yoga and prevention, vyadhi, asthana, samasya, pravada, alas, avirati, Bhranti Darshan and etc. So, here in this lecture we will see what are the obstacles in yoga and how we can come out by this type of resistances or obstacles. In yoga darshan, the formula is 1.30, which speaks vyadhistya yavan sansay pramad alasya bilati bhranti darshana labdha bhutkatvan vyavasthit tatvani chitta bhichye pastem karaya. See, there are 9 type of vyadhi, obstacle, resistance occurs in yoga. This obstacle or chitta vichheda, it is also called. It brings vichheda in chitta, chitta vritti. Causes distraction in the mind. They exist with chitta vritti like pramana, viparyaya, vikalpa, nidra, and smriti. If we are able to remove all type of obstacle, then no vritti in chit exists. Chit vritti also do not exist. Now, these 9 type of obstacles are vyadhi, asthyan, sansay, pramana, alas, avirati, bhranti darshan, alabdha bhumikat, and unvyavasthit tattva. So these are the 9 obstacles, and we will discuss one by one all these obstacles. So let us move towards the first obstacle, that is called the vyadhi. Vyadhi is related with disease, physically illness. If man is one is not physically fit, he is in contact with any type of disease. This disturbance in body is called a vyadhi. And this vyadhi is due to the following cause. the first one, according to the Ayurveda, the vyadhi in the human body is due to disturbances in dhatus. It is imbalance between three fundamental body humors. Those three type of humors are those called three fundamental those. These are called vat, pit and kaph. If anyone is either decrease or increase in their proper range, then there is kava, body illness. Second reason is disturbance in organs. So this disturbance is due to five gyanendriya, five karmendriya, and man. When there is any problem in gyanendriya, karmendriya, five gyanendriya due to which we sensory organs, and five organs through which we do the work, karmendriya and man, this causes disease. And third reason is disturbance in rasa. There are disturbances in saptadhatus, seven tissues. This is seven tissues are ras, rat, mans, nail, asthi, majja, sukra. If there are seven tissues are ras, fluid, blood, muscles, fat, bone marrow, and sukra. This causes disease in the body, body illness. So these are the, so by keeping knowledge of this and doing work according to the balance of Vata Pitta Kapha, controlling the gyanendriya and karmendriyas, and making proper functioning of all seven vasas, we can prevent the vyadhi. And by yoga darshan, this vyadhi can be removed. Obstacle see here, satyan, samsay, pramad. Here in nine, see, satyan, lack of interest or intuition. See here the diagram which we use here, we can see, this is the diagram. If you, anyone, disinterest of the mind to work for satkarma, desirable karma, then it is called inertness, lack of eternal interest of doing the right work. So it is required to continue this interest for appropriate and right work. Sunset, doubt. In this reason, the knowledge touching both ends of the subject, where it may be thus or it may not be thus. So when our mind is moving like a pendulum between two type of two or more than two results, then we are always in doubt and we are not able to take a right decision. Then this is also cause of the body imbalance, body disease. The fourth one is pramada, carelessness, negligence, introducing some problem in the body and we do not care it for negligence. The non-reflection on the mean absolute. The question of negligence is here. Now see the next one. The alasya, laziness. Inactivity of body and mind due to lethargy. We are sleeping, want to be sleeping, do not want to do the work. So this type of thing is called laziness. If we do not physically work or mentally work, then there are a lot of problems arises in human body. Because this body is to do this and work also. It's function. Now, avidity, sensuality, greediness of the mind for sense object. In this state, desires for sense object takes possession of the mind. Our mind always should for good times, work, car, money, houses. So when we are always looking the material object and attracting towards this always to get any home. So in that condition also, I give pain to our body. And it is also becomes a lot of problem in human body. Now next one. Seventh is Bhranti Darshan. Living in the illusion, wrong understanding, living in Ajnanata, have no capacity to understand the fact, truth. False knowledge of the subject, talk, or read. It do not allow one to pursue the path of true cognition. Bhranti Darshan always in the confusion. See it is. This diagram, carefully, to see the Bhranti Darshan in it. Now, we are going to see the eighth one. Allah the Bhumikattva, non-attainment, inability to hold on to what to be achieved. We are not knowing our goal of life. For what I am here? For what my birth is? In that condition, one will be always misguided. When one is misguided, then a lot of problem arises in body because their metabolism disturbs. So it is the reason. Now, Anu Vasti Tattva last, instability. Inability to maintain the achieved process, progress, stagnation or no progress. So instability, see this diagram. We are here at some particular place in the society, in body, by socially, economically, from all aspects. But if you are inability, incapable person, and we are not able to continue my positions throughout, then in that condition, the metabolism process of the human body will disturb. And that may be the cause of some diseases. After gaining some intermediate result, one may be unable to keep his mind focused to get ultimate goal. Such instability becomes an obstacle in the journey of life. So these nine obstacles distract the mind. They are also called the impurities, the enemies of yoga. If these nine are present, then one cannot do the yoga. and he cannot be yogi in the life. So, if one wants to be yogi in the life, then they must be aware about this type of problem. Now we are going to do the comparison of the 9 obstacles. This is companion of 9 obstacles, not comparison. See what are the companions. So in Yoga Sutra 1.31, the sutra is Dukh Do Man Sang Gane Jayatva Swas Prasvasa Vichyep Sa Bhur. Dukh Do Manasya Anga Me Anga Me Jayatva Swas Prasvasa. Fourth thing, see, Dukh Dor Manasya Anga Meja Yatva. And last, Swas Prasas accompany the 9 obstacles. So see here, Dukh. We are going to see all 4 parameters which help for the growth of obstacle in path of yoga. In the first is pain, dukkh, that being affected by which we try to do away with it. It is of 3 types: adhyatmik dukkh, adhibhautik dukkh, or adhidaivik dukkh. Adhyatmik dukkh is related with pain inflicted by the body and mind itself. Pain inflicted by the body and the mind. Adhibhautik dukkh, pain inflicted by other living beings, suppose another person. Adhidaivik sukh, pain inflicted by natural disturbances. So there are 3 type of reason of the unhappiness in human life: adhyatmik dukh, adhibhautik dukh, and adhidaivik. Second companion is Daur Manasya, despair. Disturbances of mind owing to non-fulfillment of some desire. We have, every person has a desire. And we can say a mind is full of desire. If one is not able to fulfill his desire, unlimited desire, then so is in happiness. So there is a percentage of unhappiness is much more. That is type of is called Daura Manasya. Third companion of 9 obstacle is Anga Mejayatva. Second is, it is a body organ which leaves the body unsteady, not uniform. Swas Prasvas, irregular heart breathing, uncontrolled irregular breathing occurs in some of the people. These all are cause disturbances in body and mind. They cease to exist when the mind is at ekagra mode. We can remove all the things by doing the mind in a ekagra mood. It is very difficult and it can be done by the yogas. In this lecture number 20, we will discuss only what are the obstacles and the companion of the obstacle, right? The remedy we will do in the lecture number 21. This is for today only. We will be surely meet with you people in the next lecture. Till that, once more, namaste to all.